Peace. Good morning, y'all. What's going on? It's day 61 of 101 vlogs, and today we got a few things on the schedule. We're gonna hit the gym. I got a recording, like a day in the life to do for somebody else for the podcast. And then I'm going to a coffee shop today to meet up and have a meeting with my friend Ace to talk over some, you know, creativity and direction as far as, you know, how I want to move going forward with content and, you know, vice versa. So there's a few things. We're getting active today, so I'm looking forward to it. But first, before anything, I'm going to get my coffee in, read my book, and then start the day. Let's get it. Get a nice good pump and workout in, because I did not go for the last 2 days. And I low-key feel a little shame and guilt around that, because I don't know. But I'm not gonna beat myself up over it, because I know that I'm still disciplined and I'm not gonna lose any of those gains that I have made throughout the months of going consistently. So it is what it is. But on another note, my friends, I have been reading this book called The Power of Positive Thinking, and it has been changing something within me. I can't say it has fully changed my mindset. I can't say it has fully changed me, but the more I read it, the more I feel it working on me. And if I could summarize this book in a few words without yapping, I would say this book is literally what it says. It is literally the power of positive thinking. It teaches us a great mindset to have. It gives us techniques. It gives us references to the Bible on certain things that we could apply into our own lives. It gives us stories and examples of what the author is offering to us, and is giving us like literal testaments of people trying out his methods. And if I could say one thing I've learned from the book, is that faith is in direct correlation to a positive mindset and positive thinking. Like, if you don't have faith, if you don't have belief in something bigger than you, then it's going to be really difficult to attain, you know, that mindset that you're looking for, that peace you're looking for, that positivity that you're looking for. I'm not sure if that makes sense, but it makes sense to me. So hopefully it makes sense to you. But it's a great book. I highly recommend it. I know that Corey, a few videos back, asked me to do a video on worrying and stuff like that. So I feel like I'm gonna be making a video soon, highlighting a chapter that I read from that book that really goes over that. And hopefully y'all will enjoy it. But yeah, man, today is going to be a long day. Hopefully I'm in the gym for about 45 minutes. Close to an hour, so I can run home, shower, and, you know, throw on something and make my way 45 minutes out to the other side of Detroit. I'll be meeting up with my boy Darnell Knox, aka Universal Footgear, and I had him recently on the podcast, and I just dropped our episode. He's a sneakerhead, and I figured, since we in the area, let's link up. Let's do like a day in the life vlog, or, you know, an in-person type of interview where, like, you're showing off sneakers. I'm asking you questions. I'm getting nice B-rolls. I'm getting good footage, just so I can spice up the podcast a little bit, just because, you know, not that it's been stale, but it could use a little pizzazz. You know what I'm saying? I could do something a little better, and I'm looking forward to that, actually. So we'll see how I feel. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. But quick backstory, I was kind of dreading doing that. And it's not because I didn't want to do it. I realize it's because it's something new. And new things I'm realizing makes me uncomfortable. As outgoing as I may look, or as extroverted as I may be, meeting new people stepping into new settings, doing new things I've never really done before by myself makes me really uncomfortable. I'm sure like 99% of the world is like that. But I always thought I was good at these things, or like it didn't bother me until I realized it yesterday when I was having a conversation with a friend. So that was an interesting revelation to have. But I share that to say, yo, if it's not making you uncomfortable, if you're not fearing it just a little bit, if you're not nervous about something, if you're not, I would even go as far as, if you're not even having doubts about it, is it truly aligned with you? You know, like, everything easy is not usually what we need to be doing. It's usually the hard things that we need to be doing. It's usually the things that make us feel super uncomfortable. It's usually always the things that we don't want to do that get us a step closer to where we want to be. Which I find super interesting. Like, why does life work that way? Like, why does life have to be that way? That's an answer that we'll never get, none of us. Because it's all in the act, literally. It's all in the act. But I'm getting to the gym. I'm about to go in here, throw up some weights in the air, and then get my day started. You hear me? Let's get it. Done, y'all. Got a good sweat in, got the endorphins running, meaning I'm in a good mood. But yo, I feel like I'm running not short. I'm not gonna rush. I was gonna say I'm running short on time, but I am just on time. It is 9:12 a.m. currently. My goal is to leave my house by 9:30. This drive from the gym back home is gonna be like 5-7 minutes. It's not gonna take me that long to shower. And I'm already thinking about what I'm gonna wear in my head. So, this big ass dog looking out that window. But, yeah. Hold up, let me show y'all. Y'all see it? He's just staring into my car, yo. That dog is dangerous. I feel like it wants to attack me. He literally is out the window right now. That's funny. But, yeah. I'm going to run home. I'm going to shower. Throw on my clothes. And then we out the door to meet Darnell. Somewhere around the other side of Detroit. So, I live in the east side of Detroit. And he definitely lives in the west side. So, and I want to make sure I'm not late and I'm just there on time. But outside of that, I'm ready for a good day, y'all. Everything's going to be good. It's going to work out as it should. If anything, it's going to supersede my expectations. And I'm going to find something good in the middle of all this. Because remember, I was just saying how, like, I was dreading it. I didn't really want to do it because I realized I was uncomfortable and nervous about it. So I'm sure once I'm in it and I'm in the action of it, I'll see, wow, I was overthinking for no reason. And I'll let y'all know how it goes. And y'all will definitely see BTS, some behind the scenes. And yeah, man, I'm ready for a day. Let's get it. All right, so it's currently 9:33. We're a few minutes behind, but
Everything is packed. I got my camera. I got my 50 lens. I got my lens on the camera. I got to get my SD cards. I got my backpack with my planner. And I got my iPad charging. And then we're heading out. All right? So let's get it. Words for anybody watching, bro. Just, man, for anybody chasing a dream, bro, anybody who's trying to get right, yeah, bro, man. Sneaker culture, whatever, man, just, you always got some wisdom and gems. So I would love for you to bless us one more time.
Yeah, bro. Straight up, man, if you are chasing your dream, I tell everybody, man, keep making noise until somebody hear you. And when they hear you, don't just make that noise. You need to be ready, so you stay ready, so you don't have to get ready, bro. So always have that mind state. You know, walk with your head up, chest high, chest out, head up, man, and just keep making that noise, bro, because, you know, sooner or later, somebody going to hear you. You consistent, and they see the love, it's going to happen for you, man. So, and I'm preaching to myself, too, as I'm motivating my own self. So just find ways to get fuel, to fuel your journey. Stay on it. Do not stop, man. You know, even if you hit dry spots, don't stop, bro. And always show love, bro, and connect. Build relationships, man. Build relationships. Building and cultivating, nurturing and cultivating relationships is key. You know, because it's a thing in life, even in the workforce. It ain't always what you know. It's who you know. Amen. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people that's in high places, they got there not only because of their talent and their drive got them there, but also who they knew. So it ain't just about only who you know, but you got to bring something to the table too. Be intentional with your relationships. Be intentional with what you asking for. And just keep it going, man. Keep it going, man.
So we're done recording the episode with UFG. It went extremely well. But now we're making our way to Desert Oasis, which is a coffee shop in Royal Oak, Michigan, to meet up with Ace, talk over some content, some strategy, and direction. I'm looking forward to this because I can use it. All right, so we're finally done. That recording with UFG went definitely well. Seven Sundays Coffee. And right now we're in Royal Oak, making our way to Desert Oasis. I wonder where Desert Oasis is. Love your sneakers, brother.
Thank you.
No problem, of course. Making our way to Desert Oasis right now to meet up with Ace and figure out some things. We're going to talk content, talk strategy. We're going to talk life probably. And yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Question to answer. You know that's hard, right?
You think it's hard. It's not.
Alright.
And you know the answer. Most people know the answer.
You know, the first word that came to me is I am creativity. Like, yeah, that's what comes to me. Like, I am, like, the impediment. You see, I almost feel narcissistic even saying that. But
why?
Because people make me feel that way.
And then again, there you go. Why can people help you or deter you or steer you anywhere?
I don't know.
It comes from,
I mean, I do know. I'll say this.
The consequence of being yourself.
Man, today was a blast. I felt like I don't even know how to explain it. It was just so good being outside in the world. Because for a long time, I've been isolated. If you go back in my videos, you can see I'm not spending time with anybody. I'm just in the crib, kind of just talking to y'all. But it felt really good to interact with people who understand and get it, if that makes sense. So I'm just wrapping up. hopefully y'all enjoyed the vlog. Let me know if y'all like this type of content. That way I could push myself to do more, not just for y'all, but for myself too, you know? And yeah, remember to like, comment, subscribe, drop some comments in the comment section. And I appreciate y'all. Thank you to all 104 of y'all. I love y'all to death. Stay tuned. Stay connected. Y'all know the vibes. See y'all tomorrow.